everyone. Hi. I would like to start my talk with a small story. Once, my teacher had asked me one question when I was in grade 1. The question was, what do you want to be when you grow up? Right from a farmer to an astronaut, I have changed my answer 22 times till now. Recently, I wanted to become a TEDx speaker, which is why I am standing in front of you all today. Then, another question that came to my mind was, what do grown-ups want to be once they are grown up? I am sure all the grown-ups in this hall would like to become young again. Forever youth is the secret wish of humans, the magic potions granting youth are mentioned in Egyptian, Chinese, Greek, and even Indian mythology. We all know about the Amrit, which was used by gods for immortality. Even in today's world, the desire is no less. Entertainment industry is the reflection of human psychology. Let's take an example of the Hindi TV serials that we see. In that, the daughter, the mother, and the grandmother all look the same age. And we feel happy seeing them because we also wish to be like them, young forever. Even our beloved superheroes are blessed with forever youth. But what is aging? What determines or influences our age? There are genetic factors and environmental factors. Let us discuss about what makes us look or feel old. Physical appearance can, which includes graying of hair, sagging of skin, wrinkles, stooped posture, but I take this point with a pinch of salt, as these days, physical appearance can be managed very easily. We have makeup for skin, Botox for wrinkles, lens for glasses, and hair color is no longer an indicator, as we have red hair, blue hair, pink hair, purple hair, and even rainbow colored hair these days. Maybe joint pains can determine aging, but I have heard that these days, our superheroes in white coats can entirely replace our problematic joints, thanks to medical technology. Forgetfulness, improper functioning of the brain can really make you feel aged. Brain is the master of our body, and it sends signals to other organs to ensure perfect internal balance. It is mentioned in most of the journals of neurology, like the Green Journal of Neurology, that very less is known about brain and its functions. But today, an 11-year-old school-going girl is going to convince you that too in the time frame of 10 minutes, that you can use the power of your own brain to keep it young. We all know that healthy lifestyle is an important aspect to slow down aging. Nothing new I will be able to add to what you already know about that. But I might convince you to implement what you already know. May I request my audience to raise their hands if they know what is a biological clock? Oh wow, most of you know what that is. That has made my job quite easier. It is a clock inside your brain. And this clock was set when you were in your mother's womb. This clock releases specific hormones at a set time. Let's take the example of the pituitary gland, which is the master of our endocrinological system. This gland releases growth hormone at a set time. The good news is that growth hormone is linked to youth. Yes, this hormone makes us grow when we are in child, and when we are an adult, it keeps us young. This hormone is secreted majorly between 2 a.m. to 4 a.m., that too in deep sleep. So, if you are chronically awake at night, it is going to affect you. Another thing that happens in sleep is the consolidation of memories. It is when short-term memory converts into long-term memory. Deep, everlasting, unshakable memories occur in sleep. So people, we must never compromise our sleep, because if you will do that, it is going to create a stress situation in your brain and that is the first countdown towards aging. It's a well-known phrase that what you become is what you eat. So if you will eat carrots, you will become strong like it. While if you will eat donuts, you will become brown like it. So choose your diet wisely. Did you know that fasting can be proved as an anti-aging factor? Yes. So whenever we don't have carbs or protein, from 12 to 24 hours, our body produces ketones, and it has a positive impact on the brain. So fasting is beneficial if done in a healthy and permissible manner. Regular exercise and strength training are well-known factors to keep you young. But now, let's talk about brain exercises or brain gym. So, let's understand what is cognitive reserve. Cognitive reserve is the ability to learn new things. The cognitive reserve of a newborn baby is 100%. She is like a newly bought canvas in which we can fill any artwork of our choice. This reserve decreases as we age. But the good news is we can increase this reserve by higher education and cognitive stimulation exercises. It is mentioned in 2019 meta-analysis that cognitive training at young age can improve cognitive function in older adults. But what is this cognitive stimulation exercise? In Bradley's textbook of neurology, lots of importance is given to new learning amongst all other cognitive stimulation exercises. Whenever we learn anything new, it forms neuronal circuits and synaptic activations, which will give you extra reserve. It also increases the flexibility of the brain to adapt. In my simple words, it is using the power of your own brain to keep it young. Examples are, learn a new skill. Sirs, please learn cooking. And madams, please learn driving, as it will not only help you learn a new skill, but it will also slow down your aging. Learn a new singing or dance technique, and once you're done with that, change the class. I would like to challenge the famous phrase, jack of all, but master of none. Although, I do agree, you should be master at one skill, and that particular skill should give you bread and butter. But once you're done being master at that skill, then you should go back to being jack of all. And when you will do that, it will increase your reserve. Small changes in daily routine can also be considered as new learning. Examples are, take different routes from your home to office. Try different foods and clothing. I have seen my uncle eating paneer paratha in Chinese restaurants. Don't keep yourself rigid. Give new exposures to your senses. Whenever you go to a new place, instead of always eating what you like, try the local food there. Learn a new language, even if you're 60. It's quite interesting to know the life story of a French citizen, Mr. Marshland, who has changed many jobs in his early and middle life. He started cycling at the age of 70, and he broke the world record in cycling till he was 107 years old. So that was the secret to live such a long life. We all know that our brain is divided into two parts. The left side, which is responsible for logic, language, and academics, while the right brain, which is responsible for creativity. The back part of our brain, which is responsible for vision and colors, while the middle part, which is responsible for movement. Even when I'm delivering this speech to you all today, my speech area, my eye contact area, my movement area, all are working together as a team. We should give different sequence of work to its members. Examples are, try eating food with both your hands someday. Try brushing with your left hand. Or try opening keys with your left hand. Try kicking football with left leg. Then, finger exercises. So the area in our brain responsible for fingers is huge. When we are using our fingers, we are actually activating a huge area of the brain. We should try doing crazy finger combinations like this. Solve puzzles, sudokus, and install memory games in your phones. Engage in problem solving and brain teasers. Remain socially active. Continue your love for reading and writing. Positive affirmations and thoughts of staying young should be constant. All these activities I have mentioned will create neuronal circuits or will activate synapses and circuits, which will give you extra reserve when the number game of aging starts, not the mind game. Brain is a powerful organ, and we should use it to keep ourselves young. Once our brain is convinced of its power, then aging is just a number game. Again, I would like to end my speech with a short story. 11 years back, my brain was so impatient and keen of growing that I came out of my mother's womb 93 days early with a weight of 550 grams. And I had 3 months of an ICU stay. I survived because my brain wanted to grow. Then, in preschool, I was labeled as autistic and I became verbal with great efforts from my parents, teachers, and doctors. Even now, I am thankful to them all. And today, I stand in front of you all on a global platform, convincing you to slow down your growth using the power of your brain. I told you, brain is a complex organ. Thank you very much, and start thinking young.